لا يزال الخير حيا لا يزال إن في الدنيا
نحمده سبحانه وتعالى حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه نشكره على نعمه علينا ونتوكل عليه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله داعي إلى رضوانه أما بعد أيها العبادة ويا عباد الله أيها الآباء الكرام وأمهات الفضليات أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون All thanks and praises due to Allah, the Lord of the universe. We thank Him. And I testify that there is none worthy of praise and worship except Allah and Muhammad Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final and seal of all prophets and messengers Allah sent as mercy for the entire mankind, the entire world, being Muslim or non-Muslim. Allah said, I did not send you except rahmatan lil alameen, as a mercy for the entire world. O Allah, pour your peace, your mercy, your blessings upon this noble, humble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and unto those who follow his footsteps until the day of resurrection. Amin ya arhamar rahimin. My dear respectable brothers, fathers, mothers and sisters in the deen, I first of all admonish myself standing before you and all of you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah. Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. He called on the believers, say, O you who believe, ittaqullaha haqqa tuqatih. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he ought to be feared. Wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. And do not die except in the state of Islam. And Allah says in the Quran again, He said, Wa laqad wassayna alladhina utul kitaba min qablikum wa iyyakum an ittaqullah. He said, I have admonished but one, the people of the book before you and all of you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah. Fear Allah, brothers and sisters. Ahibbati fillah. May their beloved ones in the deen. Ramadan. Madrasatun ta'dib wa ta'dhib. Ramadan is an institution, a school, a university, a college of character and mannerism. In Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah, the highest, the exalted one, لم يفرض علينا رمضان لنجوع أو لنعطش أو لنتعلم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not ordain or decree Ramadan on us, or prescribed it to us, for us to feel hunger, thirst, or pain. Not at all. ولكنه فرض علينا رمضان لنحقق الغاية العظيمة الجليلة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed Ramadan for us so that we will attain or achieve the greatest of all goals for being in this dunya, for coming to this world, for worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ala wa hiya. And that goal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Allah call on you, the believers, saying, O you who believe, Kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Fasting is prescribed to you. it is obligatory for you to fast. كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ As it was prescribed to those before you, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ So that you may gain piety, taqwa, God consciousness, so that you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-taqwa ayyuha al-ahibba. What taqwa, my dear beloved ones in the deen? Huwa an taj'ala baynaka wa bayna ma harramahu Allahu wiqaya. Is to put a demarcation, a boundary, between you and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden. What taqwa ayyuha al-afadil, my dear brothers and sisters in the deen, what taqwa huwa an ta'bud Allah, is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa la tushrika bihi shay'a, and not to associate him with a partner. Taqwa. بل هي غاية للعبادة كلها. Not only Ramadan, not only fasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to achieve from it taqwa, no. But every action of ibadah that you do, Allah said, يا أيها الناس, He called on you mankind, O you mankind, اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم. He said, worship thy God who created you. والذين من قبلكم and those before you, لعلكم تتقون, so that you may gain taqwa, piety. That's why we worship. This is why we fast. We did not fast for us to feel hungry, like the poor ones do. We did not fast for us to feel thirst, like those who do not have water to drink. We did not fast for us to feel pain, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need you to feel pain for you to be forgiven. No. He said, وَلَوْ يُؤَخِذُ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِظُلْمِهِمْ مَا تَرَكَ عَلَيْهَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ If Allah was to hold you, myself, and all of us ransom for the evil deeds that we do, for the crimes that we commit day and night, Allah said, I wouldn't have left any human on the surface of this earth to work. Because we are all sinners. We are all sinners. كل ابن آدم كخطاء. The Prophet said, every man makes mistakes. وخير الخطائين توابون. But the best amongst you are those who turn to Allah سبحانه وتعالى and seek forgiveness. That's why we fast. لعلكم تتقون. So that you may fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So that لتتطهر قلوبنا. So that our hearts will become pure and cleansed from shirk, from envy, from evil, from disobedience, from obscene languages of things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do not like. That's why we fast. That's why we fast. لتتحسن أخلاقنا. So that we will pave our character. Will make our character to be a good one, because the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent to perfect our character. The Quran is about character. The Deen is about character. لذلك إن شأن الأخلاق عظيم في هذه الشريعة الإسلامية. The matter, the issue of character, is a great thing in the Deen. The Islamic law. إذ هي مبنية على القيام بحقوق الله تعالى ثم القيام بحقوق العباد. The word taqwa is about character, as I said. So that character is built upon, it's about fulfilling the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rights of your Lord, your Creator. And also the rights of your fellow beings or creation. That's what we talk about. This is what character is all about. Character. A man will be assessed according to his character. And then you will know the level of his deen. The more character they have, the better character they obtain, the better they are in their deen. You get this statement right? The better you are in your character, the better you are in your deen. A deen, the religion, huwa al-khuluq, is character. And the Rasul ﷺ said, he said, al-birr husnul khuluq. Ay ad-deen, the religion is about good character. And the Rasul ﷺ said, he said, akmalu al-mu'minin imanan ahasinuhum aw ahsanuhum khuluqa. He said, the best believers, or the believers who show the most perfect faith, are those who have the best behavior. Those who have the best behavior, they are the best Muslims. According to Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he said, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, Allah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Allah Azza wa Jal, the Creator, said in the Hadith Qudsi, Kullu amal ibn Adam lah, every act of worship the servant does. The servants, all of you, all of us, whatever act we do, act of worship we do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he said, lah, that act is for you. When you pray your salah, he said, it's for yourself. When you give your zakah, it's for yourself. When you show obedience and respect to the parents, the elderly, and have mercy for the younger ones, kalimat tayyiba, good words, he said, for yourself. Illa sawm, except fasting. فَإِنَّهُ لِي, Allah said, fasting is for me, not for you. It is for me. وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِي, he said, and I will be the one to reward you accordingly يوم القيامة. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasting, ya Kareem. And then he continues saying, As-sawm, fasting, Junnah, is a shield. See what I say to you? That when you talk about taqwa, when you fast, is about character. It's about character. Ramadan is an institution. When you enter, you admit into an institution. When you come out as a perfect being. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed Ramadan for us. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Allah said, every act you do is for yourself, act of worship, except fasting. He said, fasting li is for me. Wa ana ajzi bi, I will reward you. And then he said, as-sawm, aw siyam, fasting, junnah, is a shield. He said, fasting is a shield. فَإِذَا كَانَ يَوْمِ سَوْمِ أَحَدِكُمْ, he said, when one of you is fasting, you are fasting, like today, فَلَا يَرْفُثْ وَلَا يَسْخُرْ, he said, he or she should not indulge in obscene language. You must not utter bad languages. You must not swear. You must not curse. You must not backbite. And then he said, you must not also as well raise your voice with arguments. No. And subhanAllah. فَإِنْ سَابَهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ قَاتَلَهُ, he said, if someone comes to you, the person swears at you, the person curses you, the person wants to fight you, he said, what do you say? You don't fight the person back. He said, say, Allahumma, O Allah, إِنِّي صَائِمٌ, I'm fasting. أَصَوْمُ جُنَّةٌ, fasting is shield. When you fast, you don't swear. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like those who swear. When you fast, you don't backbite.
Because Allah said, وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا He said, don't spy at one another. وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْدُكُمْ بَعْدًا Nor should you backbite one another. At all, don't do that. Allah said, أَيُحِبُّ أَحْدُكُمْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيِّتًا فَكَرِحْتُمُوهُ Would any one of you love or like to eat the dead meat or the raw meat of his or her dead sister or brother? No, you will not like it. So when you slander someone, when you backbite someone, you are eating their raw meat while they are dead because they are not there. And this is haram. It's haram in the deen. When you fast, Ya Akhil Kareem, you restrain your anger. And this is what fasting guides me and you towards. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be an example to each and every one of us. He used to restrain his anger. And then subhanallah, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, He said, مَنْ كَذَمَ غَيْذًا وَهُوَ يَسْتَطِيعُ أَنْ يُنَفِّذَ He said, anyone who restrains his anger while they have the ability to retaliate, but they don't do it. What happens? دَعَاهُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will announce the name of that person. Huh? Listen to this. When someone upsets you, when someone offends you, when someone oppressed you, and you have the ability to retaliate, you have the strength to crush them, you have the strength to do whatever you can, but you did not do it. You say, I'm going to leave it for Allah. Allah will call you Yawm al-Qiyamah. It will announce your name to all the creation from Adam alayhi salam or to the last man who lived in this world. They will hear your name being announced by your Lord, your Creator. And it will say to you, it said, حَتَّى يُخَيِّرُهُ فِي الْحُورِ مَا شَاءَ Allah will say to you, choose your حُور. Choose from those حُور الْعِيمِ The one that you desire. May Allah make us be amongst them. When you fast, you become kind, gentle. Because inna Allah rafiq. Allah is forbearing. Is kind, is subtle. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gentle. Yuhibbu al-rif. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved that gentleness. He loved forbearance. And according to Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he said, Awsani, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Khalil, my friend the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised me, bi khisalin min al khair, to do or implement these following things. These good things. أوصاني أن أنظر إلى من هو دوني ولا أنظر إلى من هو فوقي He advised me to be humble. And that is, with regards to this world, the vanity of this world, that I should look at the one who is below my standard, not the one who is above my standard. Because that makes you become ungrateful to Allah. What you have now, The favor Allah has bestowed upon you. There are millions and billions of people who wish to have been like you. But wallahi, they don't have that opportunity today. Here you are. Won't you be grateful to Allah? Can't you be grateful to Allah? Show gratitude. Allah gave you health. There are brothers and sisters who are lying down in the hospital. Allah sustained your life to see Ramadan and fast. There are brothers and sisters the very first day. They are gone. They are underneath this soil. They've gone. Be grateful to Allah, Ya Akhi. He said, the Rasul advised me to be humble. And that's what Ramadan teaches you. Because the Quran, Allah says, He said, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَ He said, a special servant of Allah, when they walk on the surface of this earth, They walk with humbleness, humility. They are humble. They are not arrogant.
They don't have arrogance in them. Because Allah said, إِنَّكَ لَن تَخْرِقَ الْأَرْضِ وَلَن تَبْلُغَ الْجِبَالَ طُولًا. If you walk with arrogance, He said, you cannot dig the earth, neither will you be taller than the mountain. This is the Quran, Surah Isra. You cannot. So humble yourself down. And then he said, he advised me, بِحُبِّ الْمَسَاكِينَ, to love the needy, the poor ones. وَدُّلُوا مِنْهُمْ, and get closer to them. Humble yourself and get closer to those deprived family, brothers and sisters who do not have what we have today. And then he said as well, he advised me to asil rahimi, to connect the familyhood. Your family are your family. Connect the ties, irregardless whether they are Muslims or not, irregardless whether they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not. Lasta alayhi min musaytir. Allah said, you're not a watcher over them. You're not the one that guides them. You're not the one that gives them hidayah. Your role, your duty is to preach to them. So this is what Ramadan is all about. When you fast, you don't swear. You don't drink alcohol. You don't smoke. You don't do all these bad things. So when Ramadan finishes, you come out as a qualified man, as a qualified sister, who is well equipped or prepared to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah said, you fast so that you become a God-conscious person. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with you amongst the people. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We thank Allah, and the peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters in the deen, before we go, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, man sama Ramadan, anyone who fasts the month of Ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaba, out of faith, and they hope to receive the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive their sins. ما ذنك بربك. What do you think about your Lord? ذن به خيرا. Have positive thoughts about your Lord. لأن الله غفور رحيم. Allah is all forgiven. This is the time you should turn to Allah, make dua, supplicate to Him. Seek forgiveness. Allah said, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Said, say, O you my servants, who have oppressed yourself. You've committed sins. You've wronged your souls. Allah said, لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not lose hope from Allah's mercy. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah said, I will forgive all sins. As long as you turn to me, you say right now, at this moment, say Astaghfirullah. Inside you sincerely, for the sake of Allah, Allah said, I will forgive you. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'an. Said, I forgive all sins. Why? Because innahu, He Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ghafoor, He is oft forgiven. And Rahim is the most merciful. And when Ramadan has appeared, an angel or caller will be calling right now saying, Ya Baghi al Khaira Aqbil. Oh, you the one who aim at the good, move forward, come forward, hasten. Wa Ya Baghi al Shar Aqsir. Oh, you the one who aim at the evil, refrain from your evil. So when Ramadan finishes, don't go back to what you used to do, the bad stuff. Don't go back. Because if you return back, that's a sign that your Ramadan was not perfect. Intend where you are not to smoke cigarettes anymore. Intend where you are not to mix alcohol with Coca-Cola anymore. Intend where you are not to go to the evil things that you used to do. Abstain from all cultural things that is against the deen. Ya akhi, let's fear Allah. Let's fear Allah. Follow the Quran and Sunnah. May Allah SWT forgive each and every one of us. Allahumma ighfir lana warhamna wastirna wa'afina wa tajawazan sayyi'atina wa tawaffana ma'a al-abrar. Allahumma tub 'alayna tawbatan nasuha. Allahumma adkhilna al-jannata ma'a al-abrar. Allahumma nas'aluka an taqabbal siyamana wa qiyamana wa ruku'ana wa sujudana wa du'a'ana. Allahumma innaka 'afuwun tuhibbu al-'afwa fa'fu 'anna. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina 'adhaban nar. Wa sallallahu 'ala sayyidina Muhammad. Qul
لا يزال الخير حيا لا يزال إن في الدنيا سلام.